Yeah. Yeah, that's on. That's on.
I came to you today to plead my case. Last year was an amazing, amazing Synthesis Teen Talent Show. It was the best year we had. You were the original. You and I, we could be something big. We could make it great again.
I'm just not getting the impression you're taking this seriously. This is a very important event that funds our whole operation. So, what do you have in vision for this year?
Doug, I grew a mustache for this thing. I grew a mustache.
Wait, come here. Real serious, yeah. What is that? I just, like I said, you're just not taking this serious enough. I'm gonna have, before I make a decision of this importance to turn it all over to you, I'm gonna have to talk to a few more associates. So why don't you just hang around outside out there in the hallway for a minute? Let me talk to a few more people.
I understand.
All right, Godfather, real talk.
All right.
I have a vision for this year's talent show, and it's going to be amazing. All right, picture this, all right? Last year's talent show, right? It's great. It's perfect, but better. I know exactly. I'm going to tell you right now. This is how we're going to do it. I'm going to be host, obviously. I mean, look at me. I'm great. But we're going to have to cut Tommy. He's just...
Your partner?
No, he's not my partner anymore.
Okay.
You can be my partner. You were the original.
I understand that. I'm looking to pass this off, hand the baton to the new generation, a new way to make the teen talent show.
And that's me.
And it's you, and it's you and not Tommy, just you.
Tommy's old. He's like 90-something. I mean, let me guess. He probably grew a mustache, and he just... Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah. It's an important decision. You know, this is a big operation. We have a lot of money we're expected to come in on this thing, so I just can't just turn it over to you right now. I'd like to talk to a few more people, and then I'll get back with you in a little bit, okay? So if you go out there and hang out with Tony in the foyer.
Whatever.
Hi there, Mr. Godfather.
Hello.
All right, I'm Forrest.
I'm Grayson.
And we have a proposition for you.
Okay.
We are going to make a great Synthesis Teen Talent Show.
Just imagine this. Sunday Night Live.
Doesn't that sound awesome?
Like the Saturday show, but better.
Yeah, basically. There'll be a lot of live skits. There'll be a lot of also video skits. And obviously the silent auction. It'll be a lot like last year, but there will definitely be Sunday Night Live passed across.
So we'll still have a lot of good talent, a lot of good actors?
Oh, definitely, yes.
All right. I like your enthusiasm. I like the idea. I like being better than Saturday night, of course. So
absolutely.
I think I'm going to give you guys a shot. What was it? What was it again? It was Mason and Jungle. What was it?
No, I don't.
What were your names?
It was Grayson Forrest.
Forrest. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Go ahead and tell Tony to send the other guys in here.
Yeah.
Come on, guys.
Hey guys, I think I'm ready to make a decision. This is a very important decision. You know, a lot rides on our talent show. A lot of income drives the whole operation all year long. So this is a very important decision. One thing that is also important to me in my operation is honesty and loyalty and bravery and those kind of things. It disturbs me a little bit that last year's hosts decided to take the chance to turn on each other when they came in for their interview.
I didn't do that.
So that's a little disturbing. So I've decided to pass it on to the new guys. What was it? Kaysen and Meadow? What was it?
That was it.
Yeah.
That's right.
So they're going to be doing it this year. But I do have some wisdom for you guys. I mean, this has been an important interview, and you guys just kind of blew it. So, you know, Connor, the shoes, really. We've talked about this before. An important interview. Those might cut it on, you know, some Bush League Saturday night, you know, Saturday night show. But this is the big leagues. This is Sunday night here.
Doug. We had the best year ever.
Last year was a very good year, yes. In fact, I have some wisdom for you, too. Here, would you mind holding OG here for a second? Hold on. I have a gift for you here. Hold on.
What's OG stand for?
Original Grumpy. So he's my OG. Here, Tommy, if you would take this as a gift, please put it on. And anytime you go on an important interview, or specifically to see me, for sure, make sure you wear that. I think it'll cover up that stench of baby puke that follows you around. So... you'll have a lot better luck in future interviews. So, And on your way out, guys, Connor, if you'd tell Tony out there that you guys need the long tour on the short pier. So you guys can go out to the has-been trailer.
I like tours.
Your fault. It's your fault. All right. Now, and you guys, congratulations. I hope you do a really good job here. You've got to know how important this is.
Absolutely.
And what was your name again? It was Jason and Gump. What was it?
Yes, that was it.
All right, yep. So we'll make sure we get that down. You do remember what happened to the last guy that blew their first big shot? You know, what happened to Ray?
What? It was Ray?
Ray Hubbard. He's sleeping with the fishes now?
Yeah.
Don't make me name a lake after you. I'm just saying. Don't screw it up.
Will do.
All right. Head on out. Good luck. Oh, and wait, one more thing. Live from Rowlett,
it's Sunday night.
Sunday
night.
Sunday Night Live. Featuring Jonathan Hewitt, Brittany Purcell, Abigail Hoyle, Abraham Martinez, Cameron Morris, Parker Morris, A.V. Treadway, Benjamin Martinez, Isabel Hoyle, Connor Collins, Jasmine Estrada, Stuart Cole, Victoria Blaylock, Anna Hewitt, Daleen Malkin, Becca Messerman, Maddie Martinez, Blake Collins, Haley Sanderson, Brandon Purcell, Nicholas Garcia, Jasmine Penniman, Risa Baselin, Paris Baselin, and special guests, Forrest Kroon and Grayson Partain. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your hosts, Forrest Kroon and Grayson Partain.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming to Sunday Night Live!
Yeah! Woo, come on!
All right. As we stated a little bit ago, it's going to be a little bit different from previous years. There's going to be a lot of Saturday Night Live-esque things going on. There'll be some live skits. There'll be some singing going on. There'll be some videos. And all of these things will showcase all the talents that our teens have.
Also, the silent auction over there. Make sure you go over there during the breaks. All you gotta do is write your name, your phone number. That's all you gotta do. And then just give us money.
That's it. All right, well, I hope you enjoy. I think we're about to kick this off, so let's get going. Woo!
Hey, I know this is kind of weird, but I was wondering if you might be able to help me.
Okay, how may I help you?
I was kind of wondering if you guys had any Cheez-Its?
Absolutely, we love Jesus. We gather on Sundays at 9:30 a.m. and 11 a.m. to celebrate that we have Jesus in our lives.
Oh wow, that's so great. Can I just show up on Sunday and get some Cheez-Its?
Yep, we have plenty of Jesus to go around.
Now, you are saying Cheez-Its, right?
Jesus.
Cheez-Its?
Jesus.
Cheez-Its.
Jesus!
I think we're on the same page.
Totally. Yeah, definitely. We're on the same page.
Decades after the proclaimed death of disco, Bookie, Wonder Man, Earth, Wind, and Fire reunite on stage for a new performance under the direction of famed producer Jonathan Sprang. Fortunately for us, the cameras were rolling.
All right, guys, I think we're about ready to go. Hey, I just want to let you know, I'm Jonathan Sprang. Yes, the Jonathan Sprang. And I got to tell you, I really love your sound.
Wow, Sprang, coming from you, that really means a lot.
Yeah, this is amazing.
I can't believe Jonathan Sprang digs our sound.
Oh, hold up, guys. I brush my teeth just like everybody else. It's just that after I'm done brushing my teeth, I spit out platinum records. Hey, you know what? Let's take it from the top of September. First time through. Hey, drummer, it's on you, bub.
Cut. Jonathan, can you come up here for a second?
What was going on, man? That was great. That was a great, flawless take.
I mean, are you sure everything was looking okay?
I mean, you ain't pretty to look at, but the performance was flawless. You know what, though? I think I could have used a little bit more dance bass. Okay. Hey, Lenny.
Yes, Frank.
Really explore the stage with your bass.
You got it.
I mean, really explore the stage. All right, take two.
Stop. Sprank, come up here.
What's going on, man? You just ruined two perfect takes. Actually, this one was even better than the first.
I'm sorry, Sprank. It's just I find Lenny's dance bass just somewhat distracting. I mean, if I'm the only one, I'll be quiet.
No, it's pretty distracting.
See?
Sorry, guys. I can take it down a little bit. Yeah. It's not a problem.
But not too much, okay? I'm telling you, guys, you're really going to want some more of that dance bass.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Yeah, that's not working for me either. I'm telling you, I need more dance bass.
Whoop. Come on, Lenny, you can't mess this up.
I'm sorry, guys. Can I just say something here? We're looking in front of the Jonathan Sprang. And I say if Jonathan Sprang wants more dance bass, I say we give it to him.
Yeah, baby.
The last time I checked, we're not selling out Madison Square Gardens like we used to. We got to give this audience a good performance. And I'll be a son of a gun if I don't dance the heck out of this bass.
Woo! I love it. I got a fever. And the only prescription... it's more dance bass.
Thanks, Spring. Look, why don't y'all just go on without me? Maybe you can form like a little moderate shuffle.
Lenny, wait. Why don't you stay and rehearse with us and dance out funky bass like only you can?
You mean it?
Yeah. I think I'm speaking for everyone here.
You know what? After I'm done with you, you're all going to have platinum rings.
What does that even mean?
Hit it.
This is Lance Johnson here at Keith's Comics, where a recent burglar has stolen all of the Batman comics.
Batman is my favorite comic person ever. And I just don't understand why someone would do this to me.
Hello, sir. What is your name?
Abraham.
Can you say that a little louder, please?
Abraham.
Hi, Abraham. Can you add anything to this tragic incident?
It was frightening. Very frightening.
Can you speak up, please?
It was very frightening.
Do you have anything to add? Can you tell me what happened here?
Some lunatic just came in here and thought he was all cool and decided to take the Batman comics, you know?
He took all of the comics?
Yeah, all of them, man. It was crazy. And, you know, I could have stopped him, you know? I could have.
Then why didn't you stop him?
Because I just got done with the gym just like an hour ago. I was all sore and everything, you know? And then I ran my pinky toe into the couch. And
that's very painful.
Yeah, you know, I couldn't do anything.
All of the Batman comics are gone. Do you know of anything that happened?
I do not know of anything that happened.
You didn't see anything?
No, nothing at all, no.
You were a witness. The police have stated that you are a witness to the crime, and you saw nothing.
I didn't see anything.
Are you sure you don't know anything, sir?
I didn't do it.
No one here is saying that you did.
Stop deathing me!
All right, well, as soon as we can track him down, we'll finish that interview because he seems to know something. Thank you. This has been Lance Johnson with Channel 11 News. Back to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mikaeli Sanderson.
We'll be right back.
right. Thank you, McKaylee. All right, at this time, we're going to give everybody about a 5-minute break to stand up, stretch, maybe get a drink, and check on those silent auction items. And please be generous with your silent auction giving, because we really want your money.
you, man. What made you even do this?
Because I'm the president.
All right, Brandon. I don't know what's going on. We're done here. Wrap it up.
From Innocence Abroad.
Correct! Give her a hand. Correct.
Good job.
Thank you.
Right. One down, two to go. Next quote. I'll never miss a beat. I'm lightning on my feet. And that's what they don't see. Mm-hmm. No, that's what they don't see.
Mm-hmm. Easy. That's from Tom Sawyer.
Correct again!
Oh, hold on. That's not true. I didn't say that. I'm pretty sure that was Taylor Swift.
Oh. Mark Twain is always joking. Trust me, Mark Twain. Taylor Swift only wishes she could write as well as you.
No, I'm not joking. I really didn't say that.
Okay, moving on. All right, the third and final quote. If you are looking for ransom, I can tell you I don't have money. But what I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills I've acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you. Shannon, your answer, please.
Alan, if I may.
Shush, Mark Twain. Total silence, please. This is for $100,000.
But you can call me Mark.
Please, Mark Twain.
But I didn't.
Shush!
Okay. I think I'm ready.
Go ahead.
The Hunger Games?
What?
Yeah!
No! I didn't even write that book. That was Susan Collins. This is getting out of hand.
I will ask you to stop, please, interrupting our game show, Mr. Mark Twain.
Right, but I didn't write The Hunger Games. And look, where are you getting your information?
The internet, hello. It's okay, you're old, we understand.
Okay, now you're just insulting me.
I see where this is going. I tell you what, let's have ourselves a little bonus round, shall we? All right, here we go. I tell you what, if Mr. Mark Twain gets this right, then Shannon wins $100,000.
Nice.
All right. Well, this is appropriate. If all the fools in the world should die, God, how lonely I would be.
Now that's me.
Wrong. That was Samuel Clemens in a letter to his wife. You lose,
what?
Sir.
What? No, I am Samuel Clemens. Mark Twain is just my pen name.
Now you're just lying through your teeth. Get off my stage, Mark Twain. This has been a very interesting edition of Who Said That. Please join us again next week.
Hey, man, what's going on?
Man, to be honest, I'm not doing so well.
Oh, really? What's happening?
I got swifted.
You got what?
See, I was listening to this one song, and... Love don't hear no more, no, I don't fear no more, but I can't respect and quite sincere no more. Oh, it's so sad to think about the good times, you and I. Cause baby, now we got bad blood. You know it used to be mad love. So take a look what you've done. Cause baby, now we got bad blood. Hey, now we got that was a good song, except for... I don't know what happened. Man, not a big fan of country, but anything over Taylor Swift. Man, this actually ain't too bad. I'm trying to see how far that I can get, but I ain't gonna lie, I wouldn't mind just a little bit of you and I, eye to eye, lips on lips, swaying to the music real close. We can both use a little let go kind of night, baby, if you want a good time. Cause baby, now we got bad blood. You know we used to be. And I don't know what's going on today. Second song so far. No! 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 This is not happening! Not again! What's going on today? No! 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 Man! Man, I just need to get away from the radio. Maybe some classics might help for today. It's actually very relaxing. Much, much better than Taylor Swift, to be honest. I wonder who wrote this. I'm looking up later, I guess. Just not while I'm driving. Might get a ticket. Cause baby, now we got
no! Bad. No! You know, used to be bad no! Love. No! So take a look at what you've done. Cause baby, now we got bad
blood. No! It's gonna be. I hope so.
No!
No luck?
None. I mean, I've had my share of tough perps, but this guy won't budge at all.
Happens to the best of us.
I don't know what to do now. We've tried everything. Good cop, bad cop, even super nice cop like Carl Winslow from Family Matters.
Well, I hate to say your thunder, kid, but I think it's time we called in some help.
What do you mean, help?
I'm talking about a legend, unmatched. Nobody knows exactly how, but this detective pulls a confession out of them every time.
Even if they didn't do it?
Even if they lied to their third grade teacher about making fart noises when she sat down. Hello? Send her in.
Her?
They call her the brat.
What do we got?
Male suspect, likely involved in a robbery. Seems like a solid case, but we can't get him to bark.
Okie dokie. Says here you were caught near the scene of a serious crime. Is that true?
Look, I don't know what it is with you people. I didn't do anything. If you ask me, I think all y'all are a bunch of idiots with nothing better to do.
I know you are, but what am I?
What?
Did you or did you not steal from Keith's Comics at Firewheel Mall?
Do I look like a comic book geek to you?
No, not really.
Then why would I steal him? I thought girls were supposed to be smarter than that.
Oh yeah? Well, boys go to Jupiter to get more stupider and girls go to Mars to get more candy bars. What do you think about that?
I think that is the dumbest thing I ever heard. Who are you?
I'm your worst nightmare. If you don't tell me what I want to hear, now tell me you robbed that store.
I'm not telling you anything.
Do it!
No!
Mom! This boy is not sharing any information. He has so much information and he's not sharing any of it. You know what else he said? He said, your meatloaf tastes like Glitterbox, you dress like an Amish janitor, and you smell like Donald Trump.
What? No, I didn't say that. Would you please calm down. Are you okay? I mean, are you always like this?
Like what?
You just had a fit like a little kid.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Oh, yeah, prove it.
Whatever.
Are you ready to confess the crime?
For the last time, I didn't.
Dad, this one just touched my shoulder. It was really creepy.
All right, all right. All right. I know he did it. I'll tell you whatever you want. Just get me out of here.
Legend. Unmatched. What a brat.
Look. If you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted in one moment, did you capture it? Just let it slip. Yo. His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his sweater already. Mom's spaghetti, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to drop bombs. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. The whole crowd goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the words won't come out. He's choking how? Everybody's choking now. The clock's run out, time's up, over, plow. Snap back to reality, oh, there goes gravity. Oh, there goes rabbit, he choked. He's so mad, but he won't give up. Daddy's, he know, he won't have it. He knows his whole back's in these ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's pro. He's so stagnant, he knows when he goes back to this mobile home. That's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody, better go capture this moment and hope it don't do it. Lose his mouth in the music, the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot, do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity comes once in a lifetime. You better lose his mouth.
Use it, break it, fix it, trash it, change it, mail, upgrade it. Charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick erase it. Write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick rewrite it. Plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, drag and drop it, zip, unzip it, lock it.
One more time.
So, right now is your 15-minute intermission, so go back there and do your thing with the silent auction. Also, just another reminder, everything that we get from this tonight goes to teen camp, which is huge for all of us, and any other activities that we do. And, you know, I mean, you could do the silent auction, or you could just, like, give the money to us. So, 15 minutes, guys. 5 plus 5.
Thank you. how do you like the new job so far?
It's great. There's just so much to learn.
Speaking of learning, it's his first day back. We should tell her.
Tell me what?
Well, we have a certain coworker who...
He just got back after a whole month off.
Okay, and?
See, the thing is, he bit someone.
Like, actually bit someone.
Another coworker.
But why?
He thinks he's a...
Oh my gosh, a shark?
Exactly. Geez, save some for the rest of us.
I'm dehydrated, Tim.
Hi, I'm Stephanie, the new assistant.
Pleasure, my name is...
Steve, in my office.
Does this happen a lot?
First of all, welcome back. How was Shark Week?
Shark Month.
How do you mean?
I DVR'd it and watched it 4 weeks in a row. It was amazing.
I see. Well, HR has decided not to fire you, but we have to discuss this shark thing.
What's there to discuss?
Steve, what you do on your own time is your business. But we can't have you biting other coworkers. It upsets people.
Does it upset people when monkeys throw their crap?
I don't suppose so. It's their own nature.
Exactly. It's my nature to bite things.
Oh. You bit Jonathan from accounting on the thigh.
He looks like a surfer. Oh.
Thank you.
Did they fire you yet?
They tell you that you were born in the back of a Waffle House?
That's enough.
Friendly sack of sardines.
You asking for a sequel, Spielberg?
Steve? No. You stop that. You stop slapping your new face. That'll be all, Tim. Thank you. Now listen, Steve. Let's get one thing straight. You're not a shark.
I am a shark.
No, Steven, I need you to say I'm not a shark.
I am not a shark.
No, that's a trick. Clever. But I need you to say I'm not a shark.
I'm not a fish.
Okay, we're getting close.
I am a shark.
No, now see, how do you...
Good news. That's great. This Friday? Of course I'll be there. I wouldn't miss it for anything. Yeah, great. Thank you. Meg, I need this Friday off.
What for?
I have an audition for Sharknado 4.
Really? What's your part?
The shark. What else?
Oh, I've had enough of this. Tell him I don't have time. I'm dealing with something right now.
He said you'd say that, and to tell you that, it can't wait.
Well, you can tell him that it can wait and that I'll call him tomorrow.
Oh, he said you'd say that too. And
I'm
you that-
sorry. Who are you?
Oh, sorry. I'm Stephanie, the new assistant.
All right, Stephanie. Well, you can assist him by telling him that I'm...
Lying? We can't be lying, Meg. It upsets people.
Listen here, you little brat. Ugh! What was that for?
I'm not a brat. I'm a dolphin.
What?
Want to go get some sushi for lunch?
I love sushi.
Let's rage!
And here you are, you're gonna come to me. Here you are, but you better choose carefully. I'm capable of anything, and everything. Make me your Aphrodite, make me your one and only.
So you wanna play with magic? Boy, you should.
no going back.
Contest. Vote now by sending a text to 214-494-9833. Do you think it was Tommy, Sprang C Group, or JR and Friends? Vote now, 214-494-9833. Let's give it up for all the contestants in tonight's lip sync contest.
Hey, boss.
Oh, hey, Forrest. I haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah, no, I've been meaning to tell you, I have a new boss. I got a new job, and I haven't been able to come and tell you because he's working me nonstop.
Well, we're going to miss having you around. What's the new job?
Well, you see, I saw this out on Craigslist that was looking for somebody named Forrest to lift stuff up and hand it to them. I know it sounds kind of ridiculous, but I'm telling you, it pays really well.
Huh, that's weird. Can't they just get it themselves?
Yeah, I guess so. I know it sounds ridiculous, but I'm telling you, it pays so well. Man, you're actually going to get to meet her. She's going to come in just a second. But whatever you do, don't laugh at her.
Why not?
You don't want to know. Oh, here she comes.
Hello. Oh, hey. Forrest told me you're his new boss. You can call me Kylie Rannon. Who told you that? Forrest.
I do not know of whom you speak.
Never mind. What's wrong?
I had my cell phone somewhere.
Is that it over there?
Oh, yeah, thanks.
What was that?
Well, it was what?
You just had Forrest go pick up your phone and put it in your hand.
Oh, right. I used the Forrest to get my cell phone.
What?
I mean, isn't it obvious? I'm a Sith Lord. I probably know my way around the Forrest.
Don't you mean force?
Yeah, that's what I said. Forest. It really comes in handy. Like, I want that salt thing that's right there, and I don't have to walk over there and get it. I just use force to get it. See? It's super convenient.
Seriously?
Yeah. Oh, excuse me. I have to take this.
Oh man, this is your new job?
Yeah, I know it's ridiculous, but I'm telling you, it pays so well. And it's really funny. Oh, here, I have some pictures.
You have pictures?
Oh, do I? Oh, this is the one time she got herself in a predicament with a snow monster. I had to hand her the lightsaber so she could cut herself down.
What? Where were you?
Oklahoma, obviously. Ooh, this one was real tough. She wanted the stormtroopers to say something really specific, and I ended up having to bribe him.
He went for it?
Yeah, he did. I had to pay him like $100, took a lot out of my paycheck. Ooh, this one was really tricky. She got her X-Wing stuck in a swamp. That one I had to use a forklift for.
A forklift? Really? She didn't see you?
Well, I guess since I was driving the forklift, by extension, it was part of the forklift, she just pretended not to see me.
So that's the whole bit? She put out a request on Craigslist for a forest so that she could go around pretending to be Kylo Ren all while you're doing the work?
That's basically it. And like I said, it's not really that bad as long as someone doesn't laugh at her. Oh, here she comes.
So I'm kind of thirsty. Can I have a Coke or something?
What, you gonna use the forest to get it?
Maybe I will. Do you have a problem with that?
I just can't believe that you would have such delusions of grandeur or be so pathetic that you would hire someone to do menial tasks for you so you can pretend to be some big Star Wars character or something. It's ridiculous. What are you doing?
I'm so sorry about this.
All right, so this is our 5-minute final auction break. This is the final, last time that you can sign up for the auctions. Okay, so also, remember to also vote for the videos. Should be, it'll go up there. Anyways, but also, like I've said before, you can just give us money. You don't have to. Auction, yeah, it's back there, but, you know, I mean, we have envelopes, we have like a bowl or something, I don't know. You can trust us to just hand it to us, too, I mean. I'm just saying. 5 minutes, final auction time. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Maddie Martinez.
Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Everyone.
Welcome to the Weekend Update. I'm Grayson Partain.
And I'm Forrest Kroom, and here are tonight's top stories. The fourth annual Synthesis Teen Talent Show was held earlier tonight, featuring two bozos reading jokes. Clearly, the talent part of the night is over. Wait, what?
After a recent Mac concert here at Catalyst, it appears hip-hop fever has taken over, and it looks like the only prescription is the Mac merch.
A recent article by Mashable.com suggests that beards are no longer fashionable, and it's time to break out those razors. But when asked to comment, our own Brad Bloomer simply snarled. Fortunately for us, JR didn't get the memo.
Ryan Moriarty has rocked the Catalyst stage for years, and now our crack team of researchers have finally uncovered Ryan's original audition tape.
Amazing, dude.
Thanks. I like to play.
The nation recently celebrated President's Day. Schools everywhere were canceled as we honored our presidents by not learning anything for a whole day.
We also recently celebrated Valentine's Day and took the opportunity to ask our first graders to explain which Hollywood heartthrobs are like our own Catalyst members. For example, Blaine Norfleet and Dr. Feinstein.
I don't know, I'm not seeing that one at all. But how about Rachel Hebert and Scarlett Johansson?
Aw, sweet. Or James Neal and Dirk Nowitzki. Yeah!
Oh, kids say the darndest things. We even have our very own power couples with Fratzy and Grizzle.
Or Brian Rogers and Tom Cruise. Now, the Tom Cruise from Top Gun, not Crazy Tom.
That's a pretty good one. How about Tiffany Sanderson and Sandra Bullock?
I like Oscar Blanco and Professor X.
Speaking of superheroes, how about Amy Dennis and Disgust from Inside Out?
Wow, really uncanny. It's like you and the Weasley brothers.
What?
Or my personal favorite, Mike Hughes, when he had his mustache, and Yosemite Sam.
The pastors at Catalyst have begun cracking down on early Beaker Mini rippers due to a recent incident where someone was recently injured by a particularly boisterous ripper. If you didn't hear about this, it's probably because you were too lazy to wake up for the first service. Here to reenact the incident through the art of interpretive dance is our very own Hannah Hewitt.
In 2011, the Catalyst Church sign got hacked by a bully posting threatening messages. It got hacked again this week, but authorities haven't yet figured out who the criminal is this time. But the posts are uniquely different than the last time.
This season of Lent is a time of thoughtful fasting, and many folks around here have given up sweets for Lent. In a related story, Catalyst is changing up our communion elements. Some members have suggested replacing our communion wafers with Nilla wafers. But honestly, I think we should just go with Oreos and milk at that point.
Catalyst online viewers have peaked during the last winter snowstorms. In recent news, Dr. Feinstein is working on a new invention, a Sunday morning snow storm synchronizer. Because, quote, have you met them? They all need help, as much help as they can get.
Speculation continues to swirl around the presence of mints in the men's restroom. No one really knows how they get there or when they'll return. Some days they're there and sometimes they're gone. Breaking news now is the mints in the men's restroom have been replaced.
Oh no! More breaking news. Now, the mints are already gone? Well, guess we'll never know what happened.
Oh, no, we won't. As you've heard, we've been investigating all of the missing Batman comics. Here to update us on the heist is our senior correspondent, Lance Johnson.
Thank you, Forrest.
As you may have known, all the comics have been stolen from Keith's Comics and Firewheel. Now, the police have not discovered any leads whatsoever, but I have received an anonymous tip to tell us what really happened. Let's take a look.
Yeah, I think this is the place.
Yeah, I think it's the Batman hoodie guy.
Yeah, let's check it out.
All right.
Oh, hey guys, come on in.
Hey.
How's it going?
Welcome, welcome.
So what are you guys doing here?
We came from Keith's Comics and all the Batman comics got taken away or stolen.
Yeah. Someone stole all the Batman comics?
Yeah, and I'm in love with him.
Oh yeah, I mean, Batman's clearly the best.
Obviously.
Who would do such a thing?
I mean, do you have any idea who it was?
No, I mean, I don't know. I mean, obviously, I love Batman as much as you, but who would steal Batman comics?
These are a lot of comics. Are you sure?
Oh, yeah. I love Batman. I've got pretty much everything that's ever been written about Batman.
I can see that. It looks like all the comics that were just stolen.
Whoa. You don't think I stole the Batman comics?
I mean, who has this much Batman? And, you know...
I mean, I do. Don't you?
Well, yeah, kind of, but I know I paid for them.
I know I paid for mine.
Do you ever see for them?
I don't have receipts for all of these. Do you have receipts for all of yours?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I don't keep receipts.
Oh, well. But this is the exact same look. I see the little string. It's uneven. Just like this. Look, it even has this little string. It's uneven.
I mean, lots of hoodies have uneven string. 100 people have that hoodie. Because I haven't even worn that hoodie since, November. It's been so nice out.
Oh, hey, guys. What are you doing here?
Hey, apparently someone robbed Keith's comics of all the Batman comics.
Yeah. And they were wearing this hoodie.
Oh.
And all the comics.
That's so weird.
Hey, stop! Oh, wait, we have some questions!
Who's going after her?
Not me, I just did a set at the gym.
Fine.
He already has every Batman comic in the world.
Because I wanted him to have two.
Aww. That's some incredible reporting.
I did all of it.
Nice job. For Connor Collins, everyone. For the Weekend Report, I'm Grayson Partain.
And I'm Forrest Kroom. Have a great week, everybody!
It's me,
Forrest Danger. Here I am. I'm trying to... My plan is to survive here for about 7 days. Alright? Oh, okay. I'm going out here blindfolded, I know where I am, and I'm going to survive, right? Hopefully I can keep myself from dying in of starvation, thirst, and whatever nature throws against me. Alright, is this the place?
That's it.
Alright, see where I am. Alright, looks like we're here in nature. I thought you said this was going to be in the Arctic. It's not in the Arctic? Oh. Alright, well... Gonna have to improvise then. Well, better get a move on. Let's go.
As you can see, this water here is pretty dirty. Now, I'm pretty thirsty, but I don't want to be drinking that. So what I'm going to show you is a trick used by the ancient natives whenever they needed clean water. What they would do is they would cup their hands like this, right? And then what they would do is they would bring it down to the water right here. And there you go, it's as simple as that. You have clean water, clean enough to drink. Alright, better keep up. Nature can be a very treacherous place. If you look over here, you see right here, this is an aspen tree. You can tell it's an aspen tree because of the way it is. Oh, no. If you look over here, this here is poison ivy. I don't want to be touching that. Come here. All right, look right here. You see this? This is a footprint of a dingo, right? Now, according to this footprint, it seems as if the dingo went this way. Come on, let's go. Okay, so this is a call used by the ancient natives whenever they tried to find the dingo, right? Cup your hands together like this, right? Put your thumbs like that and you go here. And you go. Oh no, you know what? That was an owl call. Right here. Alright. Now this here might look like a plant, but this is actually known as a stick bug. Wait, no, that's just a plant. Oh, come over here, come on. Alright, so this right here, this is what's known as a McShrubbery, right? These have very, very nutritious seeds. Come over here. Oh, here. Okay. So, right here, looks like this one is labeled as a full chicken McNugget seed. This is the pod, right? And you come in here, and there you go. Four chicken McNugget seeds. These are very good for nutrition. There. Oh, good. Oh, that's really bad. Oh, those are, oh, I can't eat that. Oh no. Alright, so what I'm gonna do instead of eating this nasty thing is I'm going to do what the ancient natives call wafting, right? Okay, so what you do is you open up the Chicken McNugget pod, and then what you do is you kind of waft with your hands like this and you sniff it like, oh yeah, that's very good. See, why the ancient natives would do this is because whenever you waft it and you sniff it like that, you absorb half the vitamins and minerals because half of the taste is in the smell. Oh yes, very nutritious. That's good. Alright, so I'm trying to figure out how late it is in the day. Problem is, I don't have my watch on me, so I can't figure that out. Now, luckily, I happen to come with my cell phone. So what I can use this for is a sundial. So you put out your hand like this and you put the cell phone there. Looks as if it's about, 10 o'clock a.m. So, looks like we've got a lot of time. Maybe we should find a good spot to find shelter and food. Come on, let's go! Come on, I think this is the right way. Alright, so, one of the most important things to know when you're surviving in this. Ow! Oh! Oh my goodness! Oh! 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 Oh, I think I broke my pinky here.
No, you're on the street. I think it's okay.
No, it hurts. You don't understand. Oh, no. I can't do this, mate. Nature is just too strong. I can't survive here. No one can. Oh, this is a lesson to you, boys and girls. Never, ever try to survive in nature. You will die. You will most certainly die. Alright, well join me next week in my next adventure. I think I'm going to try and survive in the ocean, in the bottom of the ocean. There's no trees or anything there. I should be perfectly fine. Well, until next week, I'm Forts Danger, and this is Survivor Man.
Didn't they do amazing? Wow. I am super excited. I'm super excited about how everything went tonight. It went off without a hitch. I do have some business that I need to take care of really quickly. I'm going to announce all the bid winners, okay? So we need to go through that quickly. So everybody pay attention. If everyone got an envelope when they came in. So if you made a bid and you think you might have won, pull that out so you can write down what you won and how much you need, okay? We have it all listed on the sheet out there, but if you come up with that, you know already how much your total is. It'll go a lot faster than us telling you and you writing it back there. All right, so we're gonna start the Adams family. Choloso gift certificates. You guys won the Choloso gift certificates. There we go. Okay, and let me see the amount. $30. $30. All right. Yeah, give it up for Adams. All right. All right, Alan Baugh, Bake My Day, $10 gift certificate, went for $75. Alan Baugh, $75. Baslin, $140 was the winning bid for the Studio 361 haircut for a month, for a year. So way to go there. Blanco's won for $45. They won one lawn service by BB's Landscaping. The Cashes won for two dozen rose bouquet from Flowers by Sandra. They also won for $70 sweet pickle quilts and $35 for the crib size quilt from Sweet Pickle Quilts. Let's give it up for the Cash family. It helps they're all in order of family, okay? So if I didn't, yeah, all right, so that helps. Contreras, you won for $20. You won the 8x10 canvas by Canvas This. Kroom family won for $50, the gift certificate from Max Barbecue. The Dennis family, $60 for an annual dog visit and vaccinations from Rockwall County Vet. Escamilla's, $90 was for the mystery bundle from Keith's Comics. Hey, can we give it up for Keith's Comics? What? They let us film in their store. They let us do this, all these jokes and all these funny things. And so they donated a big thing here, and they're excited to partner with us for this. So that was a lot of fun. The Fitzgeralds, $50, won an Imperia Outfitters bag from Gina Norberg. So there you go there. Forresteros, you've got 3 wins, $20 from a car wash gift certificate, $135 for the 2 dozen pastured eggs from the farm next door, and $60 for this $50 yogurt wasted gift certificate. There you go. Hewitt's, $55 for the limited edition Boba Fett 6-inch prototype from Harry Downer. Way to go. $25. Okay, Hoyle family, they won 2 things, the Chiloso $25 gift certificate and $5 for the Shenanigans $25 gift certificate. So you won 2 things there. The Hughes paid $10 for a $25 game card at Shenanigans. Kepner's, $15 from the Heart Baking by Janet Contreras. And the Rogers, $30 for the same thing, for a dozen cookies. Lindstedter's, $30 for the succulent arrangement from Flowers by Sandra, who also does the flowers here at the church, so that's pretty cool. $60, Lori Booth, $60 for 2 hours of bowling for 6 people. The Martins, for $70, one annual dog visit and vaccinations. Morgan, one for $30. Ryan's drumsticks went for $30. Thank you, Ryan, for donating again this year. We appreciate it. And it's still intact, so that's the amazing thing, is the drumsticks are still intact. All right, so the Sims, you won a whole lot here. $25 for the custom designed T-shirt by yours truly. $75 for Flatiron Hair Products combo from Studio 360. $25 for the car wash. $70 for the, $55 for the basket of hair products. And $55 for the gift certificate. So let me run that down again so you can write it down. $25 for the car wash, $75 for the T-shirt, $70 for the hair products combo, $55 for the basket of hair products, and $55 more for the gift certificate from Yogurt Wasted. Thank you so much, Sims. You're awesome. Wherever you are, I can't see you. And thank you so much for wearing all the DeMac stuff. That really helped out. Yeah, he really loves that. And the Spencers, $15 for Tummy Time Quilt from Sweet Pickles Quilts. Thank you, Sweet Pickle Quilts, for donating so much this year. That's awesome. I appreciate it. Sweeney's won for $45 free custard for a year from Culver's. Very good. And the last one, Wes Rogers, for $75, won 5 nights of luxury lodging at Stonebridge Veterinary. I'm guessing that's for an animal of some sort. All right. So that's it. I give it up for all of our winners. Can you get this down? Hey, Nick. What's that? Okay. Let me check. I'm sorry. I read all the things I saw. Okay, let's see. Okay, dinner and a movie. The Reese family, yes. The Reese family. I skipped a bunch, it looks like. Okay, here we go. All right, there's 5 things I missed. 5 things I missed. Okay, the Reese family did win a dinner for two with JR and Amanda, and you also won, that was for $200, and then you also won a Pretty Pup groom-up for $60, for $40, that's what your winner was. Very good. The Norbergs won a handmade wooden cross for $50. Thank you, Fred Sweeney, for being a part of that. And also Ryan Moriarty, you won a 16x20 canvas from for $60. $60. I think that's it now. All right, cool. Let's give it up again for them. Before we go, I know we're probably running late. Can you help me get that, Connor? It's a lot. All right. Couldn't pull this off. I couldn't pull this off at all by myself. I've already gotten a lot of compliments and thanks for the production value, for how everything went so smoothly. I can't take credit for that. It's all the sound guys and video guys and everybody back there. Amazing. And all the teens that helped edit all the videos, and that was so much fun. They did such a good job there. I also have to give a special thanks to my wife for handling a lot of the auction stuff and getting that taken care of. So let's give it up for all the people outside that helped there. And then one I have to thank really good, because Joshua Morris, come on up here, Joshua. Joshua, yeah. All the skips save one was written by this young man, and he worked with our actors, and so I just want to say thank you so much for taking this time to do that. It was amazing.
Thank you. Kind of pass it along to the actors. It was thrilling to at first watch them take a script that they had never seen before and look like a deer in the headlights, and then just over the following weeks just own it. So you guys did amazing, and I'd like every one of you to come up here so that we can have a nice bow.
That's it, everybody. Thank you so much. We'll see you next year.